Welcome back to Character Select. We're going to murder a door.
Welcome back to Wing Select, where Phinoxo eats wings.
Yeah.
If you hear me chomping.
Apparently that's... Chomp, 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 chomp.
But you
Why did the doors close behind us?
Ghosts?
Why are those doors spring-loaded?
Spooky immortality ghosts. Why do you think you're here?
We're getting close. You know what I will say, though, by the way? Uncharted 3 is my least favorite because spiders.
Because it's by what?
Because spiders.
Aww.
I hate spiders.
Or arachnophobia.
It's not arachnophobia because I can still face them. It's not like an illogical fear. I just don't like them. There's a difference.
Uh-huh.
Is there nobody here? The fuck?
Just going in. It's fine.
Nope, they found me. It's a good thing I still got this one-shot kill sniper rifle.
It'll run out soon. Don't worry.
6 bullets. 5 bullets. Oh, is this when the thing happens?
Gosh, spoilers. Now I know about the thing.
No, it's an unpleasant situation. Let's just put it that way.
I'm sorry, viewers. Sorry, Dave ruined the game for you.
Didn't ruin the game. Boom! Oh, he was already dead. Damn it. Wasn't sure. I had to shoot him again to make sure. He was already dead. Ow!
Always double tap.
Wow! Did you see that?
Mm-hmm.
Just got shot in the face with a grenade and it's just like, ow! Okay, I'm covered in snow now.
That's how grenades work.
I need that grenade launcher, though.
They just throw up everything that's on the ground into your face. And then you're really dirty and you don't want to fight anymore, so you go home to take a shower.
You might be confusing grenades with dirt.
No, grenades throw the dirt into your face off the ground.
That's not their primary purpose. Shit. Shit. Shit, snipers. Fucking snipers.
Wait, are you shitting snipers or do you want to fuck snipers?
I mean...
Because these guys don't look like Widowmaker.
We just had the same fucking thought.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Oh, God. Did that guy die? I think he died. Oh, shit! Nope! Fuck! Nope! Stop paying attention for 5 seconds and the sniper almost shoots me in the face. Also, I gotta say, you guys are pretty shitty snipers when I'm taking you... Oh, God. Taking you out with a gun. A pistol.
Thank you for that clarification.
Yes.
I needed that. Such sass.
Sorry, they're making me go into, like, straight-up panic mode when I realize that they almost have me. Because if you stay still long enough, they kill you.
Nope.
And we've been over that, so whatever. Pow, pow, pow. Oh, what? Oh, you didn't die. Where the hell were you?
It's a good thing video game snipers don't work like real-life snipers, where they're actually, you know,
stealthy,
like hundreds of meters away.
Yeah, very true. Well, a sniper is not an effective battlefield tool, actually. Okay, what happened to that? That's awesome. A sniper isn't an effective battlefield tool because they can't maintain ground. They can only kill, like, selected people, and they can only kill so many people at once. They're more for demoralization than they are for battlefield denial. I know too much about military tactics.
Way to help there, lady.
He said he got it.
Yeah, there was two handles.
Anyway, so we need to get up to that ladder. So, Elena, if you could jump on my hands, please.
Just like the fire escape.
Oh. Okay.
When you get up there, kick it down.
Oh, no.
Oh, well, we kicked it down a little too hard.
Hang on,
it is interesting how much I see of The Last of Us in these games.
Well, it's same developers and all that stuff, you know?
The only difference is guns are a lot more plentiful here.
Yes. Because it's not post-apocalypse.
There we go. Whoa. Ow. You hanging in there?
Cute.
Oh, yeah, right, just to do this. Did it. Did.
There you go.
They work well together, I gotta admit. I mean, not that anybody else in the game wouldn't work well together, but the way the game fosters team dynamics between your partners is good. I like it. The writing is essential to that.
Yep.
Hey.
Keep your eyes open.
Nope. Fucked it up. Alright. Whee!
Wow. Really? He never managed to be himself for very long.
Wow, it took forever
anyway.
For me to die.
What was the point of that?
It's a stealth. It's a surprise kill section. I like this one. Whee!
Wait, that's what you killed yourself for? To kill that one guy?
Well, also to kill that one guy because he had a pretty good gun. Oh, right in the shield. I'm really wishing I had long arm here. The long arm of the law.
No.
I had a thought, and then I lost it.
Like, totally.
Like, totally.
I was just thinking about how, like, totally cute Bobby is. Oh my god.
Oh my god. Did you see the way his butt was framed in those jeans he was wearing? Like, splish.
Come on, follow me.
I think I took that from teenager to adult really quickly.
Oh, wow. Somewhere, Thurid is just slitting her wrists.
Yeah, well.
Just hearing that discussion.
Up there.
Just like, nope. Fuck this shit, I'm out.
Oh, crap. Get down.
Well, it's a fight. Chapter 23 reunion.
Get down.
Get down! Get to the chopper!
Yeah, that was,
they are trying to take my tortillas!
That was much better than mine.
It's like the only good Schwarzenegger impression I can do. They are trying to take my tortillas! Oh shit, I'm out of ammo.
Was that actually a quote from him?
No.
Okay.
It's from, I want to say his name is, he's a comedian. His name's like, he's an amazing impersonator. He's doing like the Don Rickles voice. He's like, in a world. in a world where justice is never found. He sold tortillas on the corner. And the mob wanted in. Get down! The time to take my tortilla! It's so fucking awesome.
Wow.
I wish I could remember that guy's name, but I can't. It's like, I want to say his last name's Fernandez, but I don't think that's correct.
Yeah, I got no
wow,
idea.
I couldn't move.
Also, you're dead.
It's like a... Sorry, I was taking a drink. It's like a... it's like a 5-minute bit, start to finish. And it's just it just keeps getting better. You're like, what is happening?
Have you ever watched Rick and Morty?
No. You and Sonara keep telling me that it's the best show ever. I've
it
never
is.
Seen
it. It is. Oh my god. There's a bit like that where they do like interdimensional television.
Mm-hmm.
So it has all these ridiculous TV shows and commercials. And one of them, like, you can tell they're just ad-libbing in the recording space and then they just drew in the shit they were saying.
That's like the best too, right?
It goes on for like 3 minutes, and the title just gets longer and longer as the ad-libbing goes on. It's fantastic.
I somehow feel like that's the way they do a lot of Archer stuff, but I know they don't, because that stuff's really scripted.
Yeah.
But I feel like they make... Oh, fuck's sake. I feel like they make a lot of changes to the script as they're recording in that show.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't think it's very difficult for them to change what's shown.
Well, yeah, the... Like, they had the whole animation style figured out back on Adult Swim.
Yeah.
Was it Frisky Dingo? Was that the name of the show? Or...
Is that the same studio?
No. I think that... I'm thinking of the wrong thing. There was one that it had, like, the same Archer-looking guy. But he was, like, an Iron Man-type superhero. And he had, like, this small, like, army of, like, Iron Man-type henchmen. I know I've talked about this with someone in this community before, too.
When was it on?
Adult Swim, so... Late at night.
Like what years? Because I didn't watch Adult Swim for like 5 years.
Oh, a long while before Archer.
I may not have seen it. Because I know Frisky Dingo I never actually saw.
Right, I'm going to type some things into my keyboard and I'm going to apologize for what that's going to do to the audio here.
Taka, 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 taka. Fuck your rockets! Fuck your shotgun!
Oh no, I think it was Frisky Dingo. Wasn't that the same group of people? Really?
They did do Frisky... I'm basing this on the conversation that Danny had with Aaron on Game Grumps.
Uh-huh.
I believe they did do Frisky Dingo, yes.
Yeah. Yeah. It's like the exact same animation style and the main character even looks sort of the same. His hair is different. There's some other slight differences.
Archer is just one of those shows that's just completely ridiculous.
I love it.
And is so much the better for it. Like, they take, like, the standard tropes of spy movies and stuff like that, and then you're like, I think I know how this is supposed to go, and I think I know what they're going to do with it. And then they take, like, a third option, and you're like, what the fuck?
It just goes completely into left field.
Yep.
You should watch Rick and Morty, man. It does that a lot.
Yeah, I know. Like I said, I don't watch a lot of TV. Like, I don't have time. I got so much shit that I work on all the time.
No, I understand.
I mean, you make time with Sonara, but when my wife wants to watch TV, she watches freaking Game of Thrones and Outlander. Outlander is awesome, by the way.
I'd like to point out that the only thing I've made time to watch with Sonara this week has been Game of Thrones.
Ugh.
So we're no better.
Hodor.
Hold the door, Dave. Hold the door.
All right, we made it. Yay, that stupid room is done.
We did it.
It's okay. Hey, look, it's a reunion.
He's totally okay. All that blood on him, it doesn't mean anything. Everything you touch does turn to shit. Come on,
we're gonna get you out of here.
No. What do we do?
Did you find my expedition?
No, don't move me. I already shit myself.
You understand what I had to do?
Yes.
If they had found the stone, it would have changed the course of history.
Easy, easy.
Can't let the Nazis have the stone.
He took the dagger.
I know.
He's gone to the tower. You have to stop him.
Try not to move.
This monastery hides the secret path to Shambhala. You must get the dagger back.
How convenient.
Find the secret path.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's why everything has been brought here.
He gets his hands on it. Drake. You have to believe. Oh.
Schaefer.
Oh, Nate.
Oh, Nate, he really did shit himself.
You don't actually have to believe in anything.
You heard him.
Do you think
are
you gonna tell that to the dying monk?
I don't know.
You're gonna be like, look, I don't actually have to do that.
But he believed it. That's enough for me.
Nate's not really a believing kind of guy. Yep, close the door so we can't go back in. Good call.
Okay.
Opening doors is hard.
What?
No, listen. I'll go scope out the secret entrance thing, and you go to the tower and figure out how to get that dagger back.
Lady, do you watch horror movies?
Yeah, alright.
We're not in a horror movie, though.
Just keep your
hand. I don't know, you were fighting fucking Wendigos or whatever.
Okay.
Good luck.
Fucking abominable snow yetis.
Yeah, well, I mean, that was somewhere far away.
You fought zombies in the last game.
I mean, just that one time. More platforming! Oh, shit. I fucked that up.
Yeah, you did.
I had the right idea, I just fucked up the execution. Let me try that again. Grab! Whoa! There we go. Don't jump across that, please. Okay. So, I guess that's the tower we're trying to get to.
Get there. I believe in you.
And the platform back just collapsed, so we can't go backwards.
Of course.
It's too far.
Oh, hey,
too far
look.
Of a jump.
Waist-high walls and bad guys.
Broken neck bad guys. Oh, no.
They go together like peas and carrots.
Wait, is there another guy here?
Does anyone actually think peas and carrots go well together?
Okay, A, do you not like peas or carrots?
I like peas and carrots individually. I don't like them together.
I think they're just two vegetables that are easy to put together. Although I guess technically a pea is a legume. I don't know how that works. I don't know what a legume is.
Look at this guy spitting out words that he doesn't know the definitions to. Jim, put the definition of legume on the screen.
We did that like two episodes ago. It's not a running joke anymore.
Put legume up there. And then figure out if a pea is actually a legume.
Oh, shit.
And then put that up there. And then put up a picture of a pea in a top hat.
No! Whoa! You're going a little too far there, my friend.
Wait, what's wrong?
How did you guys not fucking...
What's wrong with peas and top hats?
I don't know. I'm against peas getting notions above their station.
Dave, how much have you had to drink today?
Nothing.
I'm the sleep deprived one.
Where am I fucking going? Where was the... That's the tower. So I gotta go down, right? I think. Doesn't look safe. Can I drop down here? Nope. Okay. Apparently that was a fall that was just slightly more than my own height.
It's fine, you did it. You win.
Yay! I do like winning. It's sad but true. What's up, buddy? Snap. Need that?
Neck crack. Drake, American Ninja.
He is a freaking ninja sometimes. It's ridiculous. Am I supposed to go that way? I'm supposed to go this way.
Wow.
How was I supposed to fucking know that?
I guess use your eye holes.
Use your eye holes, maybe.
Use your mom's eye holes.
Whoa. To do what, exactly?
Show her freaky deaky porn with right before I b**k her.
Wow, Jim, bleep that out, please.
Wait, bleep out
bleep that out too, please.
Really?
You heard me. Do it.
But what if you find, like, a skeleton and there's bones everywhere?
That's fine. Context is everything.
What if I was to take one of those bones and hit your mom with it so that I was beating her?
That would be funny.
Okay.
Also horrible. What do you have against my mom? I'm like kind of agreeing to it for a second, and then I'm like, wait, what? Hold on a second, you dickbag.
I'm saying perfectly reasonable, normal things.
Yes.
Oh, time for the Zombos. Or Yetis, more likely. Bulletproof Yetis.
What are they? Oh, Bulletproof Yeti! Oh, two Bulletproof Yetis. The fuck? I don't think I want to be here. Are they gonna get chased away? Okay, they got chased away. So now it's time... What the hell was that? Alright, so I gotta figure out how to get down. This is a good way to get down. Loving an elevator, living it up while I'm going down. Pew, 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 pew. Sorry, living it up while she's going down is the technical lyric, but I suppose both would work.
I like the imagery that generates in my mind. It might not be the intended imagery, but it's what I'm going with.
I figured you'd be okay with that. You do like the... So, you know, Jim, bleep that out.
Which part?
God. Yes. God damn it.
That was just the most pathetic looking ragdoll.
Mm-hmm.
Just face down in the snow.
I'd like to point out that Nate's been wearing the same jeans since he arrived in Nepal.
It's fine.
Master Ninja!
He just goes to the bathroom in them anyway. And then it freezes and then just, like, breaks off inside them. So they're still clean. That's how that works, right?
I don't think so. Also, this is another one of those sequences can do stealthily, not really interesting. Stealth takes so long to do that it's almost never worth it. Stop shooting me, please.
Does stealth take longer than losing and restarting two or three times?
It depends. Okay, there are four fucking heavy armor guys. Okay, there's one heavy armor guy left. Sweet, that worked out well. Stop shooting me, please.
Do you regret not stealthing?
A little.
Well, that was a pinpoint grenade.
Alright, let's see if I can do this. Give me a little bit of health back, thank you. Boom! There we go. Anybody else? Anybody else?
Yeah, the Yetis.
Nope, everybody's dead.
Gotta have more Yeti boss fights.
I mean, sure. Is there a treasure over here? No? Okay. Thought maybe there would be. It seemed obvious. A little too obvious, I guess. Yay, Yetis!
Yep.
Hooray for Yetis! Of the E variety.
These games are weird, man.
They're Uncharted. This is like Indiana Jones modern day. Indiana Jones had freaking face melting things. And
when do we get some face melting?
I don't think that ever actually happens, at least in the first three
games.
That's
all I want in these games is face melting.
Well, you're going to be disappointed then. Sorry. Yeah, this is the part. Fuck. Remember those guys that keep showing up and I'm like, we don't have to fight them? Those guys with the big miniguns?
Oh, them! Yeah, you have to fight them now?
Now I have to fight them now. Hey, if you want to know how tough they are, he just took four grenades to kill.
That's fine.
Fortunately, his buddy is Tweedledummer. There we go.
Bring it!
Oh shit. I did that incorrectly.
Smooth.
McGroove.
I love that guy. I love that guy.
He has a fabulous singing voice. He has a delightful cat. And he has a fabulous beard. How can you not love that guy?
His pussy's pretty great. I want to touch
it. Oh, you just said that. That's a thing you just said.
Yeah. I want to, like, grab hold of it and rub my face against the fur.
Seriously, is your armor so heavy that you can't hear anything? Because grenades are not quiet. Don't be a dumpy. Be a doobie!
Double kill!
No rockets for you. Sky rockets in flight.
Boo! Afternoon delight.
I know how to run and gun game. What the fuck? I've been doing it. I got the freaking medal for doing it a lot.
Ooh,
what the hell?
Afternoon delight.
Just a song about having sex.
In the afternoon.
As a delight. Oh, what the fuck? So there's a specific way that I could try and do this that if I pulled it off would make this a lot easier. Problem is, I gotta kill both of these guys first.
It's fine.
Okay. Goddamn mutants. No.
The thing looks like it has five or six grenade barrels.
It has six, but for balance purposes, they limited it to four per reload.
Literally the TF2 Demo Man's grenade launcher, then.
Didn't his start off with six?
It did.
And then they had to nerf it?
But then he was an unstoppable murder machine, so they lowered it.
I find it difficult to believe that having six grenades instead of four, it makes you unstoppable. But
I might be exaggerating a little, but it means that they can do that much more DPS in a short amount of time.
True.
And or they can also spam 50% longer.
Ah, fuck. Boom! Right in the face. That did not kill him.
Knocked off his helmet.
Yeah. I didn't even realize that I had to shoot him twice.
Kick him twice. Boom. Not unless you've got gun fists.
What did I say? Okay. You can fuck right off.
Oh man, that'd actually be kind of a cool idea.
What?
For like a fighting game type character. What? Someone who has like gauntlets with what amount to like miniaturized pistols behind the knuckles.
That's the principle behind the displacer fist in Fallout New Vegas.
Yeah, and just like a pro.
Also, I have a minigun now.
Yeah, I see that.
It is, pound for pound, the single most damaging weapon in the game, including rocket launchers.
What?
It can tear down a light armored shotgun guy in like seconds.
Why'd you get rid of it?
Because I can't move and jump while holding it, so it sucks. That's why I was saying, if I killed those two guys first and I could get to a minigun, I wouldn't have to worry about anything. But I couldn't get to the minigun, so.
Gotcha.
Where am I going? Am I going up here? Oh, maybe. Can I get into those windows, maybe? Maybe?
Nah. Star, scoot on up into those windows.
Why are you talking?
I don't know. Why not?
Why? Because it's creepy.
Because I'm sleep deprived and weird and on the verge of going to sleep.
You said nothing about being sleep deprived when we started this recording session.
I know.
It's Because is it because you're such a cool dude who doesn't afraid of anything?
It's because it's Sunday, and I've like we all know this at this point. But I will bring it up when I need an excuse for acting erratically.
Or you could just say, "Hi, we haven't met yet. My name's Phinoxo."
Nah.
Oh, shit.
Now that's more your deal.
Oh shit. I'm not weird. I'm like the least weird person on the channel.
I meant that statement, but if you want to take it as being weird, sure. That mannerism is more your deal.
True. True.
I just blame being tired or alcohol or both.
Here we go. Now I'm in a place where I can be in a place.
I should start smoking pot so I have another excuse.
I've never done pot.
I think we talked about this before, actually.
Yeah, we've had the drug discussion. I don't do drugs.
Don't do it, kids.
It's not from any kind of high moral ground. It never interested me.
Unless you're in Colorado, then say okay.
Just lay low and stay out of their way.
Climbing the rocks, looking for a place to go.
Why didn't you tell me all of these things during that long car chase we had where we nearly died? Or during the long gunfights where we nearly died? Or when you were blowing up priceless towers and we nearly died? Oh, yeah.
So, for the record, the official reason why Nate is able to continue fighting at this point, even though it's one against 17 billion people, is because now they have to worry about the Yetis. So, they're more concerned about the Yetis than they are about Nate. What the fuck was that?
I like how there's apparently a, like, someone felt the need to sit down and work this out and then distribute it around, while they didn't bother coming up with any such excuse for murdering an entire convoy full of guys with automatic weapons.
Ooh, finally. Tower.
Like, well, that's totally fine.
He's just that lucky.
Killing two guys with chain guns?
If this were a legit movie instead of a video game, Nate would probably kill at most, like, 20 people. But it's a video game, and killing people is what the game is about. Ergo,
I thought it was about
he kills a lot of people.
And story.
That too.
I'm tired of your excuses.
So this is the tower. This is supposedly where the entrance to Shambhala is. Hey, look who it is.
I have given
this chapter is called Reunion, so I guess we're having another one.
Brought you the dagger. Now, where is the gate to Shambhala?
Oh, she's hot.
Look, Zoran, we know...
I have not come this far to be thwarted by your incompetence.
We know the answer is somewhere in this room. We just have to find it.
Meanwhile, Drake remains just one step behind you. I clearly hired the wrong man for the job.
Yeah, a little bit.
What an asshole.
I'll try to smooth things over with him. Just stay here.
I kind of want his jacket. It's a nice jacket.
Oh, it looks kind of beat to hell. Or you mean Drake's?
Yeah. Okay. No. No.
The bad guys?
What's his face's?
Yeah, bad guy. That's his name.
Yeah.
Bad guy Thompson.
Harry. Harry Flynn. Harry Flynn. That's what it's called.
God, that booty.
Nate? Get out of here.
Give me the dagger.
They'll be here any
Chloe,
minute.
Chloe, don't make me take it from you.
How am I supposed to explain where it's gone?
I don't really care.
Think of something? Do.
No kiss.
Just do one thing for me. Take that son of a bitch down.
Yeah, no love lost between them.
Aww. But I want them to smooch.
All right, so it's time for more puzzles.
Next time on Character Select.
Which means... Yes, indeed. Next time on Character Select.
I just wanted to say that.
Time for more puzzles.
If it's actually time.
No, it's a good time to break. We'll take a break here.
Sweet.
It's fine.
Dave, what do you have to say for yourself?
You screwed up the outro, man. Come on.
Press the like button.
No. Thank you very much for watching. Make sure to press that like button down below. And Phenoxa, what do you have to say for yourself? Ha! Turned it around on you. Alright, Jim, bleep that out.